Next, we will see the compound microscope. It has two lenses. One is objective piece. Second is eyepiece. Yeah, objective piece means a convex lens which is near to the object. Means an object is placing in front of a convex lens of a compound microscope. That piece is called objective piece. And where we are watching the image, that image through eye, that's why it is said to be eyepiece. So let me check some dimensions. So this is the objective piece, one convex lens. In front of it, one object of height h was standard. Then this object is at a distance of u. Then from the middle of the aperture of this objective lens to the image formation, we have the distance f naught. So next one, this image will become the virtual object for the eyepiece, and this eyepiece has focal length fe, and this image will form just behind the objective piece, which is virtual and erect. And this image to the aperture of the eyepiece is called d, which is equal to the least distance of distinct vision. So how can you distinguish the magnification of compound microscope when compared to the simple microscope? Suppose if this is the case, up to here we can apply the rules of a simple microscope. Means it is simply one convex lens which is similar to the structure of simple microscope up to this part, up to this BAH dash. So now how can you understand? So what is the magnification of the object? We can say that h dash by h is equal to minus v by u. What is v? Distance of the image. So the distance of the image is, we can write L. What is this L? The tube length which connects these two lenses. By object is placed at F naught. But if you see the tan beta is equal to H by F naught. So H by F naught. From this one, H by F naught, we can write H dash by L. So magnification of the eyepiece is 1 plus d by fe. We know this. If the size of the if the position of the object is at infinity, image forms at f. If the object is at, image will form at infinity. These are the reciprocals to each other. So if this is the case, if this is infinity, we can neglect the 1. So therefore me will become d by fe. So what is m naught? Means magnification in the object, l by f naught. So the total magnification m is equal to m naught into me, object magnification. Objective piece magnification into eyepiece magnification. So the M naught is L by F naught. ME is D by FE. So where L is the tube length which connects the eyepiece and objective piece. Let us say this one is 20 centimeters and F naught is 1 centimeter. D is the least distance of distinct vision, 25 centimeters. Eyepiece focal length is, let us say, 2 centimeters. Means focal length of the object to piece and eyepiece are related to twice. So because of the largest aperture also, it can be possible. If we substitute all these values, therefore m is equal to 20 by 1 into 25 by 2. Therefore 220 10 times. So we will get 250 times magnified image. 250 times magnified image means we can enlarge the object size into any way. So this is the advantage in the compound microscope. In a simple microscope, we are getting simply a 6 times. But in a magnification of compound, it may be raised up to 250. But we can adjust the magnification of the simple microscopic also by adjusting the focal length of the lenses. But the structure is simply a difficult one. So we are seeing the telescope. There is some differences when compared to the microscope to the telescope. In microscope, objective piece and eyepiece has a large nature. Means objective piece focal length is less and size is less, and eyepiece size is more when compared to the objective piece. That is the structure of microscope. But in case of telescope, objective piece has high focal length. But eyepiece has low focal length, and we can see the differences in the sizes also. So if you suppose in this case, one light ray enters to the objective piece, converges by an angle alpha and creates an image, and this image will become the virtual object for the eyepiece, and we will see the object like this, see the image of this one like this at the eyepiece. So if this is the functioning, so we should get the magnification of object and magnification of image both. So what is the total magnification? Beta by alpha. What is this beta? Angle made by the image. What is this alpha? Angle made by the object. So what is alpha? So we can write h by fe into f naught by h. How we will get this? So what is beta? So this is beta. So h by fe. So this is the h and this is fe. So that's why h by fe. What is alpha? H by f naught. So this is alpha, this is the size of the object, and this is f naught. So h by fe into f naught by h. So therefore h and h get cancelled, we will get magnification is equal to f naught by fe. And this objective focal length by eyepiece focal length. This is the small information about the telescope. So what is the actual use of telescope? Telescope actually gives the resolved image. Suppose if two stars are separated by some distance, we can, if you want to see the two stars which are in the sky, we should rotate this eyepiece with some angle, and that angle is gives the resolved image. So in this resolved image, so the magnification is f naught by fe. Let us suppose objective focal length is some 100 centimeters, eyepiece focal length is some 1 centimeter. Let us suppose. So then the magnification we will get 100 times. There are two stars separated by a distance. Then we want to see the two stars. If you rotate the telescopic eyepiece through 1 degree Celsius, then this magnification in the angle will be 100 into 1 degree. That means 1 degree is 67 minutes like this. So this much angle is needed for the 100 times magnified lenses to rotate the angle 1 degree to see the stars clearly. But there is some difficulties to construct the telescope of high resolution. If you want to get the high resolution, there is a need of high aperture lens. Yes, we can take the aperture lens which are of high size, but it is very difficult to bear them with any connecting rods. So that structure will become a complicated one. So rather than using this convex lenses, if you use a concave mirror inside the telescopic lens, then it might be useful for the larger magnification. So then now we will see what are the modifications did by the different scientists. With spherical lenses, there is a problem of aberrations. That is also one of the problem. So to avoid these aberrations with the spherical lenses, this is the modified structure of a telescope. So in US, they made one 40 inches of a telescope with a large size of lenses. So 40 inches means 40 into 2.54, you will get some 1 meter length. So it is very difficult to bear them with that size of lenses to observe any celestial object. So for that purpose, they have one eyepiece. The modified version is like this. They have some primary wavelets on primary. And these primary wavelets are incident on the secondary mirror, and by the making of angle of incidence, and they will reflect, and these reflected light waves will converge at the principal axis of the eyepiece. So what is the use of mirrors in place of lenses? Lenses has aberrations, mirrors don't have aberration. They used to reflect the light very properly, and this properly reflected light converges at the eyepiece, and there may be a possibility for the high resoluted image. So this resolution should be great, and this type of modified telescope are called Cassegrain grain telescopes. So in India, the largest size telescope is in Tamil Nadu, Cavalur. So what is the use of, means if you, the, with respect to the size of the secondary mirror, we can see the convergence of the light rays on the eyepiece, and then we can resolute the large distance objects also, where the focal length is increasing. So if this is the case, focal length increases, convergence will increase, at the same time you can get the high resoluted images and perfect images of the celestial object. Like this we can see the telescope use. So whereas the telescope is giving the resoluted image, microscope is giving the magnified image. In wave optics we can see the angle of resolution takes place for the telescope. So the theta is equal to some 0.61 lambda by a. If aperture is less, theta will be more. So like that we can take the telescopes as useful. So in this lesson, what we have started with the reflection, refraction, total internal reflection, after that the uses of the total internal reflection, next some natural phenomena due to the sunlight and to the optical instruments. This one is a very, very important one for the students who are preparing for the theoretical exams like IPR, CBSE. We can get some beautiful problems, and in this point, if you have the time, we will discuss the problems afterwards. So with this point, I'm concluding this lesson.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.